Hey guys, Keith here with Rack and Rod Chronicles. Today I'm gonna kind of walk you through my clothing for our backcountry hunting trip for elk. Basically, we're gonna be running through mostly SKRE gear. I don't have all the pieces right now. Some of the stuff I have on is on order, it's on back order. So I'll kind of tell you what I'm gonna use. We'll start at the base layer and kind of work our way up through there. I'll give you some kind of back and forth between a couple options between the two that you could use, what I prefer versus some people might have allergies to it or just don't like it. So to start off, we're going to start our base layer. First off, you want a set of probably two pair I would recommend of merino wool or some kind of synthetic based underwear. I like the boxer brief kind of deal. Something like that. They make longer ones that go like just above your knee. That's kind of what I like because they almost kind of double as long underwear, to give you a little bit more insulation on your upper leg. And if you have your lower leg, if you have some, at least throw in one pair of like just below the knee socks. It's almost like having long underwear on without having it on, the full restriction of it. You can have shorter socks in to cool off a little bit more. So I'll start off with that. I like the Kaibob. The Zip T Merino Wool 150 weight top, which I have that here. So it's super lightweight. I really like this. I've been using Merino Wool here for the last few years. It's nice because it doesn't stink. Once you get sweaty and you're gonna be in backcountry, you're gonna be sweating and getting stinky. So it doesn't matter. That doesn't really affect you that much on that. Dries really quick. Stays warm for how light this is. It's surprisingly warm. This is straight through, like I said, it's a Mach-T with the zip, so you can open it up in the front to cool off. It's got a little chest pocket here, just big enough for some mouth calls or that, or a pack of matches or something like that. And pretty much straightforward. It does have the thumb loops there for getting in and out of your jackets and stuff, so you don't have to worry about sliding up on your arms, and or if you wanna keep like, if you don't wanna wear gloves but have a little bit more of your hand covered, it'll do that too. But it's pretty much straightforward, and this is in the Summit pattern. Really like it. It's kind of like a good universal. It's got browns, grays, tans, greens in it. It works pretty much all season long. Really like that. Same thing for the long underwear. I will probably throw in a set of the Kaibob, the 300 weight long underwear, because we're going to stay fairly light on the pants because it's going to be early season, but you never know if it's going to get cold. But you could also use that at night, just for sleeping in your sleeping bag so you can get your pants to dry out and stuff if you got wet during the day or anything like that, or you're just not bringing in that grime and back in your sleeping bag. So that's what I'll probably set up for that. So two pair underwear, one set of long underwear. I've been a fan of the last couple of years of the Darn Tough socks. These are just a couple pair I have. These are the shorter ones, like the just above the ankles version. I'll probably bring like two pair of these in early season. And then I'll probably bring one of those just below the knee height ones, a little bit warmer. And I can use those in the morning on a cold morning if I have those just to stay a little warm and you can change out. So I suggest probably you're gonna want to switch your socks once a day. So you have two pair, then you have another pair to sleep in. So that's a good thing. And then you can rotate them through. Because if your feet get wet and damp, that's when you're gonna get blisters and your feet are gonna get cold. Even in the warm weather, if your feet are sweaty, you're gonna get cold. So socks there, and so these are merino wool. These are great socks, the Darn Tough socks. We're not sponsored by them, but they're lifetime warranty. You wear a hole in them, take them back to a store, they give you a brand new pair. Great socks. Okay, so we got base layer pretty much covered. So that Kaibob shirt was like that. I might throw in a second shirt, like a t-shirt if it's really hot, and that Kaibob, the same line, just a t-shirt. Or if you don't like the Zip Tee, they make a crew too. Any of those three you could do. You could even have two of the shirts if you want to have one for a little bit of layering. But that's where I would start. It's kind of personal preference on that. Depending on what the temperature's looking like right before the trip is probably where I'll depend if I'm gonna throw in an extra t-shirt or not. And you could use that for sleeping at night too, so you can kind of mix and match that. Getting more into our outer layers. For the pants, I'm gonna use the hard scrabble. I don't have those right now. They're on back order for me. I had to do a size change. But they're like a soft shell, same as the Kaibob, the hard scrabble vest and the jacket. They've got a nice set of pockets on them, zips. They also have heat mesh heat zips on the side of your legs just by your pockets there, which are a really nice feature. I've never seen them on any other pants, but if you're hiking in when you get hot there, you can zip those and it lets some heat dump out of there. So that's a really nice feature, especially in this early season where it's going to be cool in the morning, it's going to be pretty hot in the afternoon. So that's a really cool feature I like on those. They're a little bit lighter weight than these jackets in that same category, but they have just have like a very soft inner lining on them. So it feels warm if it's on your skin. It has a nice brushed material on the inside, which is nice. Where the vest and the jacket is more like a soft shell, so it has that little bit more of a fleecy lining. But the hard scrabble pants are more like a brushed in the inside, which is nice. It gives you a little bit more warmth in there. Lighter weight, early season pants. I like the hard scrabble as that in between gives you a little bit more warmth for, you never know if it's gonna get cold or not. But with those little zips to let the heat out, it kind of helps bridge that gap in between. They're pretty much a do-it-all pant. So moving up on the upper body, the next would be the Kaibob 300 Merino Wool Hoodie. Now that's another thing I'm waiting on. It's on back order right now. We're in the early part of the season, so their orders aren't coming in, haven't quite come in yet to restock after the holidays. But that'll be my go-to piece. I have a similar Merino Wool Hoodie that I've used the last 2 years, and I love it. For how thin it is surprising how warm you stay with it. So that is your main piece, and it's got that hood you can just throw up, but it's thin enough that you can still hear through it if you have it up over your hat. It's not like a big jacket where you can't, it kind of muffles your hearing. So it's very nice like that. That'll be my main layering piece, or if it's just a little bit too cold in the morning when I'm hiking in on the trail or eating breakfast, I'll do that. Then we will switch to what I'm wearing right now, which is the vest. Depending on what the weather's looking like, probably depending if I take the vest or not, I might switch out and take, if it's gonna be unseasonably cold in the forecast, might switch the vest out for a puffy, just to give me more insulation factor for sitting around camp or we're gonna be doing a lot of glassing and that, depending on the terrain. But most likely I would keep the vest, but it's nice. You can keep your core warm, block the wind, especially if you have that Merino 300 weight hoodie on. Keeps your core warm, but your arms are still very easy to move for drawing your bow back and stuff. There's no restriction. Because Merino wool, the one thing about that is it's very free moving. There's no pulls in that. It's got a little stretch to it. Where the soft shells in that can be a little bit more restrictive if it's tight anywhere. So I use the vest. The vest is set up real nice. It's got four pockets, two in the chest, two in the waist. It's got a drawstring around the waist, so you can cinch that down if it's real windy to keep it from any airflow coming down. And it's cut pretty long. It kind of goes below your butt a little bit. So if you're sitting down, you can kind of give a little bit of protection there from your pants and that, from getting totally wet. And the soft shell, it's got a Teflon coating on it. So it's not waterproof, but it repels the water very well. All right, so that would be what I use for more of my active stuff. And then if I'm sitting or if it's raining, depending on the weather, I might just try to go with the hard scrabble jacket as my rain gear. Or if it's looking pretty wet, it's kind of playing by ear, depending on the location. If it's more of a wetter climate, I would probably take an ultralight rain jacket with me. Probably not the pants, because honestly, when you have those pants on, you usually sweat in them, even if they're breathable. You sweat in them just as much as you would get wet, as long as your upper body is, especially if you have a pack on your back. The back of your legs are pretty much protected from the pack, and you're kind of hunched over, so you're really not getting that wet. I would probably take the opportunity to throw a set of gaiters in, for your lower legs, for when you're getting wet in the grass and stuff, to keep the water from going down your boots. That probably would be my better use of weight if I was gonna do that way, and more useful. And then make some short ones, high ones, and gaiter wise. SKRE has some. I don't have any of the SKRE gaiters, but I might get them for this trip. I have another set of another brand that I'll probably use depending on what the terrain actually looks like. That would be the deciding factor of what you actually need in that. And everybody's gonna be slightly different in that. Like, these are personal preference, things like the vest. Some people might not want the vest. I do like vest just because of the movement of your arm and it's a good layering unit underneath. Hat-wise, this is just a basic ball cap, mesh in the back. I will probably take a Merino wool, lightweight Merino wool beanie to have on for sleeping at night and or if it gets cold to throw on. And I'll also have a Merino wool neck gaiter. I really like those. Even that with this, you can pull it up over the back of your head. It's almost like wearing a hat. If you don't like those, then make the Bakulas. You can put over too. They have a merino wool one like that too. I know I'm doing the hand motion, but it's kind of give people an idea if they know what it is. It's kind of the face mask and the beanie all in one. Depending what you like. I wear glasses sometimes, so I don't like those as much because they kind of stick up over your nose and then they fog them up. Where the neck gaiter, I can wear it down just under my chin, and it just works better that way. So the last thing will be the jacket, and this is the hard scrabble jacket. So it's basically the same exact setup as the vest, except it's got sleeves and it also has a hood. And the hood is really nice. It's like the cut, like a hunter cut. It swoops in around your ears, so you still have pretty good visibility. It's got a little bill on it that'll kind of go right over your hat. So it kind of keeps everything good. It sheds the water very well. And with this and this on, it stays pretty warm. So the puffy would only be if I'm really going in an area and they're like calling for snow or something. That would probably be where I would change out from the vest to that, just in the case that I'm going to need more insulation than on average than this. But this, if you're wearing this, the vest in that, the two layers of merino wool, you're going to have a really good base on there and you're going to be able to handle them pretty good. And we're talking early season, so the chances of that are pretty slim, and I would probably feel pretty safe with going without the puffy in your early season. But the only thing the puffy would probably save you is probably would be a little bit lighter than this vest, just because they're down puffy. There's not much to them. So depends on that in space wise, but the amount of the gear, how I have, I was laying out, I should have more than enough room that I'm not going to really be worrying about that. And this is a good option to hike in if you need that little bit more and it's windy and that, because it blocks the wind. It's the one thing about the soft shell, they block the wind really well. For the amount of thickness that they are, they're kind of deceiving in how warm they actually are. So that is my basic gear list for my outerwear. Like I said, everything is in the SKRE and the Summit pattern. I really like that pattern. And so I'm missing a couple of the pieces, but I think Greg showed some of those on his. So you'll be able to check it on there or go on their website. They have a bunch of stuff there and they have their kits set up. You can kind of go. If you go right on there, they have basically some of the kits we're using is right there. They have like an elk kit, a different level of starter kits. They have it set up really nice. You get pretty much everything you need in one package and you can do everything with it. That's the one nice thing about it. So the only thing I don't have is possibly a rain jacket. I think it's the rain jacket, my pants I'm still waiting on, and my hoodie. So the rain jacket, I'm on the fence about if I'm going to do it or not, because these jackets are pretty good. And if it's honestly, if it's really pouring out that much, I'm probably going to be sitting in a tent or have a little portable tarp up and just waiting it out a little bit, because it's pretty nasty being out in the rain, soaking your bow. It's not really the best thing to do is soak your bow and your bowstring and that, stretching out in the backcountry. You don't want to push it too much, slipping on a rock with a broadhead. Probably sit back and do a little glassing instead. All right, guys, stay tuned for our next episode of the Gear List for the Backcountry Elk Hunt. Take care.